students, good morning everyone. In our last class, we have studied about the criteria of a good estimator. So what is the need for this criteria? Because one estimate will be having different estimator. That means more than one estimator will be there for estimating one parameter. So in that case, among those estimators, to find the best estimator, we use the criteria of the good estimator. So what is considered as a good estimator? The statistics value which falls near to the true parameter value, that is considered as the good estimator. So according to R.A. Fisher, there are four characteristics of the good estimator, right? What are the four characteristics? First one is unbiasedness. But the estimate value. So this is the condition for the unbiasedness. What is the second condition? Second condition is consistency, right? What is the consistency? That suppose if Tn is any estimator, then Tn tends to be the in probability. So this is the condition for the consistency. And to check the consistency, we are having two conditions. First one is expectation of Tn tends to theta as n tends to infinity, and the second one is variance of Tn tends to 0 as n tends to infinity. So if these two conditions are satisfied, then this estimator Tn is said to be the consistent estimator. Then what is the third one? Third one is efficiency. Efficiency. So whenever you have more than two estimators which are satisfying both unbiasedness and consistency, so among those to choose the best one. Efficient means better than the previous one or better than the other one. So to compare that, we will use the efficiency. So whichever estimator is having the less variance, that is considered as the good efficient estimator. And the last one is sufficiency. What is sufficiency? Here you will be considering the conditional distribution of Tn given the sample values x1, x2, so on, xn. So that conditional distribution should be independent of theta values, that is parameter values. So these are the four conditions for the four characteristics for the good estimator. Now we will see the some results related to unbiasedness. So first we will consider all the problems or results related to unbiasedness. After that we will be studying the next characteristics. So now today we are going to start about the results on unbiasedness. Very important problems. So all these problems are very easy. At the same time they are important also. So coming to the first result is that, for in the first result we are going to prove that sample mean is unbiased estimator of population mean. So always it may be any distribution or any population, always the sample mean is denoted with x1. So this sample mean is unbiased estimator of population mean. Unbiased estimator of population. So this is the first result. We are going to prove that sample mean is an unbiased estimator for population mean. So now first we write the statement. So coming to the statement, first you have to consider a random sample, right? So first consider the random sample, that is let x1, x2, so on, xn be a random sample. Be a random sample drawn from the normal population. So here are considering that they are drawn from the normal population. Drawn from the normal population with mean mu. With mean mu and variance sigma squared. So that normal population is having the mean mu and variance sigma squared. So what does it indicate? Small xi, that is the sample values, follows the normal distribution, that is the population, normal population with mean mu and variance sigma squared. Now what we have to do? We have to prove that sample mean is an unbiased estimator. So what is the condition for unbiasedness? Expectation of statistic. What is the estimator we are considering? Sample mean. So expectation of x bar should be equal to the theta, that is parameter bar. What is the parameter here? Population mean. What is the population mean? Mu. So expectation x bar should be equals to mu. So this is the condition we are going to prove now. So we have to prove expectation of x bar equals to mu. So first I have to find the expectation of x bar value, right? So for that, consider expectation of x bar. So what is x bar? It is a sample mean, right? And what is the value of sample mean? 1 by n summation I equals to 1 to small n xi. You have to write small xi since it is a sample. Since x bar equals to 1 by n summation xi. Now bring the constants outside. So what are the constant here? 1 by n is a constant, right? So 1 by n expectation of summation I equals to 1 to small n small xi. So summation I equals to 1 to n xi can be written as x1 plus x2 plus so on xn, right? So write that one. 1 by n expectation of, apply the summation, what will you get? X1 plus x2 plus so on up to the last value is small n. So xn. So you will be getting this value. So this is nothing but, if you apply expectation inside, what you will get? 1 by n you write as it is, and apply expectation for each term. What will you get? Expectation of x1 plus expectation of x2 plus so on plus expectation of xn. So here we have expectation of x1 plus expectation of x2 so on plus expectation of xn. So this is the addition of the expectation of x values. So this can be written as summation 1 by n summation I equals to 1 to n expectation of xi. So expectation of summation xi can be written as summation of expectation of xi. So this is the value of expectation of x bar value. But here I want expectation of xi value. I don't know the sample mean value. Expectation of xi means sample mean. So we don't know the sample mean values. We only know the population mean is given and population variances are given. So I need to find the value of expectation of xi. So how to find this expectation of xi value is, what is expectation of xi? Mean value. So always expectation of any value, how can you write? If it's a discrete distribution, you will write summation over x into p of x. Summation xi into p of xi, right? If it is continuous, we will write integral over x into f of x dx. So here it is a discrete. So expectation of xi, how will you find? Summation xi into p of xi. But how will you find this xi values? All are sample values. We don't know the sample values. We know only the population values. So whenever you are drawing the sample, whatever the value is there in the population, that will only you will draw in the sample, right? So this small xi values take values of the population. Suppose I have 10 numbers, right? From that I am taking the sample of 5 values. So I will be getting from 1 to 10, the numbers in the sample will be obviously from 1 to 10. That is, sample values are taking few values from the population. That means they are taking the population values only, few values of population with the probability 1 by n. Because total there will be n values. From that you are picking one value, so probability will be 1 by n. Similarly, again you are drawing one more sample unit with replacement, so 1 by n only the probability will be constant. Since we have the probabilities and small x size, that is sample values, takes the sum values of population. Now since xi, so what is small xi? Sample values takes the sum values of population. Sum values of population means that sum values of capital Xi with the probability 1 by n. So since we are choosing one element, that is one unit from population, the probability will be 1 by n itself. So in place of small xi, we can now write the capital Xi. Now I will consider expectation of xi. I want expectation of small xi value, right? So consider the value, consider expectation of small xi. So here what, how will you write the expectation of xi? Generally summation xi into p of xi, small values. But here sample values will be taking the population values. So this can be written as summation I equals to 1 to capital N. So here sample values are taking population values. So I will be writing summation I equals to 1 to capital N xi into p of xi. So how will you write this one? This p of xi value is 1 by n constant. That is for all sampling units, p of xi is constant. So expand the summation, what will you get? X1 into p of x1. So this is equals to x1 into p of x1 plus x2 into p of x2 plus so on up to xn into p of xn. So now what is p of x1 or p of x2, p of xn value? 1 by n. So substitute that value, x1 into 1 by n plus x2 into 1 by n plus so on up to xn into 1 by n. Now take out 1 by n common. 1 by n if you take common, what will you get? X1 plus x2 plus so on plus xn. So x1 plus x2 plus so on plus xn is nothing but summation xi. So expectation of small xi equals to 1 by capital N summation I equals to 1 to capital N. So here you have to write capital N. This is capital N. 1 by n summation I equals to 1 xi. So what is 1 by n? It is population value, right? 1 by capital N summation I equals to 1 to capital N capital xi. All are population values and this is the population mean formula. So expectation of small xi equals to, what is the value? 1 by n summation xi is mean formula. So what is the mean of the population? That is, population mean is given as mean. So here expectation of small xi equals to mean. Now substitute this value, keep it as equation 2. Now substitute equation 2 in equation 1. So what was our equation 1? Expectation of x bar equals to 1 by small n summation I equals to 1 to small n expectation of small xi. So this is equation 1, right? Now substitute equation 2 in equation 1. Therefore, expectation of x bar equals to 1 by small m, summation I equals to 1 to small m. What is expectation of xi bar in the equation 2? Mu. Substitute the mu value. Now, if you observe, we have to apply the summation, but there are no I terms. The summation is ranging from I equals to 1 to small n. So, in place of summation, I can write small n, right? So, 1 by n into small n into mu. So, n and n gets cancelled. Expectation of x bar equals to mu. So, here expectation of sample mean is equals to the population mean. So, whenever expectation of statistic equals to one parameter, hence that statistic is for the unbiased estimator. So, therefore, sample mean, so it may be any distribution, always the sample mean is an unbiased estimator for population mean. Therefore, sample mean x bar is an unbiased estimator of population mean mu. So always remember, the sample mean is an unbiased estimator for the population mean. So this is the first result related to unbiasedness. Next we'll move on to the second result, where we will be considering the sample variance. So sample variance, it is denoted with small s square, and population variance is denoted with sigma square. Now we will check whether that sample variance is an unbiased estimator for the population variance or not. Now the second result is, sample variance is, sample variance, what is the sample variance denoted with? Sample variance is denoted with small s square, right? So sample variance s square is not an unbiased estimator, is not an unbiased estimator of the population variance, of population variance. So population variance is denoted with sigma square. So expectation of small s square is not equals to sigma square. We have to prove this one. And but, so here we have a condition that, but if you consider the s square equals to 1 by n minus 1, summation I equals to 1 to n, xi minus x bar whole square. So what is s square generally? 1 by n summation xi minus x bar whole square. So instead of the sample variance, if we consider the mean square, this is called the mean square. 1 by n minus 1, summation I equals to 1 to n, xi minus x bar whole square. So this is capital S square value is an unbiased estimator for, is an unbiased estimator for the sigma square, that is population variance. So what we have to prove here? Expectation of small s square is not equals to sigma square, and after that we have to prove that expectation of s square, where s square equals to 1 by n minus 1, summation I equals to 1 to n, xi minus x bar whole square is equals to sigma square. So we have to prove these two things. So for that, summation I equals to 1 to n xi minus x bar whole square. So first consider the sample variance formula. So this sample variance can also be written as 1 by n summation I equals to 1 to n xi square minus x bar square. So for simple calculations we will be using this formula only, right? The simplified formula. We have used in the correlations also the s square value as 1 by n summation xi square minus x bar square. Now I will find the expectation of small s square. So expectation of small s square is expectation of the s square value is 1 by n summation I equals to 1 to n xi square minus x bar square. Now apply expectation to two terms separately and add the constants outside. What we will get here? 1 by n is constant, so 1 by n summation also you can write outside. I equals to 1 to n expectation of x I square minus expectation of x bar square. Now we want the expectation of x bar square values and expectation of x I square values. So how to find this values means we have the variance formula, right? What is the variance formula in terms of expectations? We know that variance of x equals to expectation of xi minus expectation of x whole square. Expectation of x minus expectation of x whole square. So this is the general variance formula in terms of expectations. Here I am finding for the term xi. So variance of xi equals to expectation of xi minus expectation of xi whole square. Now what is expectation of xi value? We have got in the theorem 1. In a result 1 we have, by putting the unbiased estimator for sample mean, in that we have equation 2. In that equation 2 expectation of xi value is nothing but mu. So here variance of xi equals to expectation of xi minus mu whole square since from result 1. So now we have to find this variance of xi value. So how do you find expectation of any value? So what is the expectation of any value? How do you find the expectation? In the last we have done expectation of a value means summation over the value into p of x. If it is continuous, integral. So here expectation of xi minus mu whole square. So this can be written as, so here also sample values will be taking the population values. So in place of small xi, I will be writing the capital xi values. So how will you write? Variance of xi equals to capital xi minus mu. So this is equals to summation over expectation of any value means summation over I equals to 1 to capital N, because sample values take the population values xi. So here also in place of small xi I have to write capital xi minus mu, capital xi minus mu whole square into p of xi. So what is p of xi value? P of xi means the probability, right? So what is the probability of drawing a unit? Probability of drawing a unit is always 1 by n only. So if you expand this one, what do you get? First x1. So x1 minus mu whole square into p of x1 plus second term is x2 minus mu whole square into p of x2 plus so on plus the last term is xn minus x capital. x1 minus mu whole square into 1 by n plus x2 minus mu whole square into 1 by n plus so on. The last term is xn minus mu whole square into 1 by n. Now take 1 by n common and this can be written as x1 minus mu whole square plus x2 minus mu whole square plus so on plus xn minus mu whole square. So this can be written as summation over I equals to 1 to n xi minus mu whole square. Variance of small xi, right? Variance of small xi is equals to 1 by n summation over I equals to 1 to capital N capital xi minus mu whole square. So here what is mu? Mu is the mean, that is expectation of xi. So what is this formula of 1 by n summation I equals to 1 to capital N xi minus mu? This is the variance formula, right? So here you have all the capital values. So this variance of small xi is equals to sigma square. So variance of small xi equals to sigma square. Now substitute variance of xi formula in the before equation. Here we have variance of xi equals to expectation of xi minus mu, right? So in that equation you can substitute the variance formula, sorry, variance value. So, and also we know that write the variance formula. Equals to expectation of xi square minus expectation of x bar whole square. So this is a formula for the variance in terms of expectations, that is variance of xi equals to expectation of xi square minus expectation of xi whole square. So we know the, now I want the expectation of xi square value. So because in our previous equation here we had expectation of xi square, right? So to find that value, I am finding expectation of xi square value as, if I want this value, variance of xi minus expectation of xi whole square root becomes plus expectation of xi whole square. So what is expectation of xi value? Variance of xi we got it as sigma square, and expectation of xi value is mu. So simply we can write it as mu expectation of xi square. So you will be writing mu square. So this is the value of expectation of xi square. So now consider the considering expectation of x bar square. Now I am considering expectation of x bar square. So here expectation of xi square means what we have written? Variance of xi plus expectation of xi whole square. Similarly like that, expectation of x bar square can be written as variance of x bar substitute that value. Expectation of x bar square equals to variance of x bar is sigma square by n plus expectation of x bar is mu. So l by mu square. So this is the variance of expectation of x bar square. So here we got this value. Keep it as equation 2. Previously we got the expectation variance formula we have written, right? Before that we had equation 1. And this value to keep it as equation 3. Now we will substitute this equation 2 and 3 in the expectation of s square value. In the starting we have written expectation of small s square, right? We are finding number of estimated for sample mean. So in that formula, you substitute the expectation of s square value. What was our equation 1? Expectation of small s square equals to, one second, 1 by n summation, expectation of xi square, 1 by n summation, expectation of xi square minus expectation of x bar square. So now I got the expectation of xi square value and expectation of x bar square values also. Now I will substitute those values. This is our equation 1. So 1 by n summation I equals to 1 plus small n, expectation of xi square value is sigma square plus mu square, sigma square plus mu square minus expectation of x bar square is sigma square by n plus mu square. Now here if you observe, there are no items, so here also in place of summation I can write n, 1 by n into sigma square plus mu square minus sigma square by n plus mu square. If you observe, n and n get cancelled, plus mu square minus, right? Minus mu square gets cancelled. So you will be left out with sigma square minus sigma square by n. So expectation of small s square equals to 1 by 1 minus n into sigma square. So expectation of small s square is not equals to sigma square, so therefore s square is not an unbiased estimator, is not an unbiased estimator for sigma square. So we have proved our first condition. Now we will check out the second condition. So now for the second condition, so here we got the expectation of small s square equals to 1 by 1 minus n into sigma square. So consider the form. If you take the LCM there, what you will get? Expectation of small s square equals to n minus 1 by n into sigma square. Now, expectation of some value should be equals to sigma square, right? So I will keep sigma square here as it is and send the remaining terms to left side. Here you have n minus 1 by n. So if I send to this side, it will become n by n minus 1. So write this n by n minus 1 inside the expectation and substitute the small s square value. What is small s square value? 1 by n summation xi minus x bar whole square. So here small n and small n gets cancelled. You will be left out with only 1 by n minus 1 summation xi minus x bar whole square equals to sigma square. So what is this value we have considered in the statement only? That is capital S square. So expectation of S square equals to sigma square. So this S square equals to 1 by n minus 1 summation xi minus x bar square is an unbiased estimator for population variance sigma square. So always sample mean will be unbiased estimator for population mean, but sample variance S square is not an unbiased estimator for population variance sigma square. But if you consider S square equals to 1 by n minus 1 summation xi minus x bar whole square, that will be unbiased estimator for sigma square.